Now, what we have to do, just we have to find the dot product, U and V. Dot product of U and V should be zero. Why it should be zero? Because it is stated that U must be perpendicular to velocity. So here I have to find the dot product. If I want to find the dot product, then we have to multiply X component with X component, Y component with Y component. It will be 12 into 12. It means 144 plus 16 into 16 minus 10t, and it should be equal to zero. Then we can solve it. It becomes 16. मैं 16 से डिवाइड कर देता हूं, एक तो कैंसिल हो जाएगा. 9 प्लस 16 माइनस 10t इज इक्वल टू जीरो. एंड नाउ 10t इज इक्वल टू 9 एंड 16 25. इट मीन्स t इज इक्वल टू 2.5 सेकेंड. 2.5 सेकेंड. In 2.5 second, the velocity becomes perpendicular to its initial direction. I hope this is clear to all. Please copy it. It is a very important question. I hope आपने copy किया होगा. See, this is very easy question. I'm just checking for the making you more clear. In the graph shown in figure, the time is plotted along x-axis. Which quantity associated with the projectile motion is plotted along y-axis? And tell me the answer. What is the answer of this question?
None of above.
Yes, it is right. None of these is right. अगर आप इसमें मान लीजिए none of these के बदले आप direct answer words में देना चाहते हैं that there is no option, you have to answer this, then what should be here? क्या होना चाहिए?
डिस्प्लेसमेंट.
इट इज एक्सेलरेशन.
वेलोसिटी एक्सेलरेशन.
एक्सेलरेशन वेलोसिटी बेटा डजंट रिमेन कांस्टेंट इन प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन. प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन में एक ही चीज कांस्टेंट होता है, वो है एक्सेलरेशन. आप जानते हो एक्सेलरेशन इज ऑलवेज डाउनवर्ड एंड इट्स वैल्यू इज जी. Clear? Any doubt?
No, sir.
Good. क्या हमने ये क्वेश्चन किया था? क्वेश्चन नंबर 15 या क्वेश्चन नंबर 16? क्वेश्चन नंबर 16 करते हैं. 15 काफी इजी है, वो टू डायमेंशनल मोशन का था. Try to solve question number 16. It's also very interesting question. मैंने कुछ questions खोज-खोज के लाए हैं आपके लिए कि आप कुछ concept को याद रखो, समझो. A projectile can have the range, same range R for two angles of projections at T1 and T2. To be the time of flight in the two cases, then the product of the two time of flight is directly proportional to what? See, range is same. It means what? It means angle of projection for first is theta, then angle of projection for the second is 90 minus theta. If ranges are same. But क्या मैंने सही लिखा? Now see, we have to find the time and its a product. Angle of projection, if t1 and t2 are the time of it, then product of time, yes. So just find the time, t1. You know, t is equal to u cos, sorry, sine theta upon z. Then t2 will be what? 2u sine 90 minus theta upon z. Then it will be 2u cos theta upon z. This is t2. Now this is your t1 and this is your t2. Now if we multiply t1 and t2, we will get 4u square sine theta into cos theta by z square. Now this can be written as 2 upon z. I have just separated 2 upon z from this. 2 yahan se le liya, z yahan se le liya. Now u square 2 sine theta into cos theta upon z. See, this can be written as 2 upon z u square sine 2 theta upon z. Now what is this? This is the range. It means you have got a very interesting result. T1 into T2 is equal to 2 by z r. This is the result. And now you can answer it. The product of two time of flight is directly proportional to r, because 2 by g is a constant. And you must have to keep this relation in your mind. Ye kai bar use hota hai. Okay. Please copy it. Sare questions jo bhi main bata raha hu, those are very interesting. They are काफी मेहनत के बाद इन टाइप के क्वेश्चंस को सर्च करके मैं आपके लिए लेके आया हूं. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर. सी, ये तो क्वेश्चन हमने कर लिया था इस टाइप का. क्या हमने ये क्वेश्चन कल किया था? क्या हमने ये क्वेश्चन कल किया था?
यस सर.
गुड. नाउ सी, क्या हमने ये भी क्वेश्चन किया था? क्या हमने ये क्वेश्चन किया था?
यस सर.
गुड. दिस क्वेश्चन, नो. Yes, we have done this question. This question.
भूल गया सर.
कर लिया है?
Yes, sir.
Good. मैंने एक question और लिया था. ये question मुझे मिल गया. मैंने पहले also एक question किया. But just I'm just coming back. मैंने question यहाँ रखा है, वो एक बार देखते हैं. One interesting question is here, so I'm just searching. See, question number 92. See this question. A cell is fired vertically upward. This question is very easy question, but there is the twisting. So please try to understand. A cell is fired vertically upward with a velocity v1. Vertically upward throw kiya gaya from the deck of a ship traveling at the speed of v2. Ship is moving with the speed of v2 and shell is fired vertically up with a velocity. And see what is the concept behind it. Yes, V1 and V2. Okay. See, how can we solve this question? Kya kah raha hai question? A shell is fired vertically up, V1. And the ship is moving with the velocity V2. The shell is fired from the ship. It means shell will gain the velocity of ship also, because the person is standing on the ship and ship is moving with the velocity of V2. Then this velocity is already with the shell. Means the shell is possessing this velocity in its state of rest, and one velocity is given, V1, in upward direction. It means the shell has to move in this direction. In this way. और यहां पे आप एक बहुत ही इंटरेस्टिंग रिजल्ट देखोगे, वो क्या है, ध्यान से सुनेंगे आप. R is equal to, we know, U square sine 2 theta upon Z. मुझे विश्वास है कि आप ध्यान दे रहे होंगे, इट विल गिव यू अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग रिजल्ट. वी कैन राइट दिस U स्क्वायर इनटू 2 साइन थीटा इनटू कॉस थीटा अपॉन Z. नाउ सी, वी हैव रिटन 2 हियर एंड U साइन थीटा इनटू U कॉस थीटा upon Z. अब देखिए क्या चीज है, what is this? This is the U vertical, and what is this? This is U horizontal. In this way, we can write this formula: 2 U vertical into U horizontal upon Z. This is the range. Means the range can be written in this way also. So here, if we want to write the range, then see the vertical velocity is V1. This is V1. And horizontal velocity is V2 divided by Z. This is a very important result. Okay, क्या आपको समझ में आया? Anyone can tell me?
Clear, sir.
Good. Okay, now we have 10 minutes to start circular motion. I'm just moving to the next topic, circular motion. Circular motion. I'm just bringing a circle. I have brought a circle here. See, when an object is moving on this circle, try to understand the things clearly. Here the direction of velocity is this. This is the direction of velocity. Here the direction of velocity is this. and here the direction of velocity is this. Means the direction is continuously changing. So there are two possibilities.